गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स।
गुड मॉर्निंग मैम।
या गुड मॉर्निंग। गुड मॉर्निंग।
गुड मॉर्निंग मैम।
ऑलराइट, सो क्विकली लेट्स टेक अ रिकैप ऑन व्हाट वी डिड इन द लास्ट क्लास।
यस मैम।
या एनीबॉडी कैन गिव अ क्विक रिकैप ऑन दैट? एनीबॉडी क्विक? Who is Halima Misba?
About proper.
Ma'am, it's me, Huma.
Mathematical.
Ma'am.
Who?
Ma'am, we did proposition.
Huma, ma'am.
1 minute, please. 1 minute. Halima. Who is Halima?
Ma'am. No, ma'am. It's Huma Bushra, ma'am.
Huma. Okay. So if you log in into with some other ID, we don't get to know, and I don't want to allow anybody else other than our students.
Okay, ma'am. I'll change it, ma'am.
No problem. Today you can continue.
Yeah, ma'am.
Yeah. Somebody was ready to tell me the recap on yesterday's class. I'm sorry for the interruption. Yeah. Go ahead, please.
Yes, ma'am. Propositional logic we did.
Yeah.
That logic, then logic.
Yeah. Tell me.
Yes, and declarative statements. What are declarative statements? Then we worked out on some sentences, whether it's propositional or not.
Exactly.
Then we talk about prepositional variables.
Right.
Then basic connectives.
Right, connectives. That's where we very good. Good.
Yes, ma'am.
So, we have talked about what is propositional logic. We spoke about what are propositions. We took some couple of examples on how, whether each one is a proposition or not, why something is a proposition and why something is not a proposition. We saw that. And then we went in for what are the basic connectives and what exactly is a primitive statement and a non-primitive statement. I think that's where we stopped the last class. Let's continue. Let me quickly share my screen. You are able to see my screen? Yeah, right?
Yes, ma'am.
So,
yeah, ma'am. Yeah.
Okay, fine. Well, let's continue. So now let us begin with basic connectives. That's where we stop. Let me begin from there. So we were talking of, when I say basic connectives, connectives are basically used to combine the primitive statements. So that is where we stopped yesterday. We took some examples of what are primitive statements and what are not. Primitive statements are those which cannot be broken down further. Am I audible or is there any breakage in my voice?
No, ma'am.
There is any issue from my end, please do let me know. Okay, fine. So we saw what are connectives are basically combine the primitive statements. And I also told you that the connectives can be of two types. I don't know if I told that. Connectives can be of two types. One is transform, the other one is combine. Now, when I try to list out the basic connectives, okay, I try to list out the basic connectives, I start with the first one, which is negation. It is always denoted like this. We can also denote it like this. Okay, the first symbol, this one is more convenient for me, so I'll stick to that. We have the next one is the conjunction. Conjunction is represented like this. Okay. And then we have the basic one more connective is called as disjunction. This is our disjunction. We have the next one is implication, which we represent it with an arrow. And then we have what is called biconditional, okay, which I represent it with a two-headed arrow. All right. Now, these are the basic connectives which we are going to learn. So you have to join before the class starts. Once I come to this side of the screen, it is difficult for me to get back there and admit you all. Please be on time to the classes. Right. So biconditional, this is how we represent. Now, I told about two things. One is transform and one is combine. Now, when I say connective, I told it is used for combining primitive statements so that we can try to come out with what is called as compound propositions. What do we mean by compound propositions? Compound proposition is any two or more propositions. When I try to combine, that is what I call it as compound proposition. Am I clear? If I am having two propositions, I try to combine them using some kind of a connective, then I call that as a compound proposition. Let me take an example. For example, let us say today is Wednesday. Okay, this is one proposition. And then I say no class today. This is another proposition. When I combine these two using some kind of a connective, I will get what? Today is Wednesday and no class today. Something like that. Okay, that one I call it as a compound proposition. What is a compound proposition? When I try to combine two or more propositions, then I call it as a compound proposition. So today is Wednesday is one proposition. It is a primitive statement because we cannot break it down further. We have one more proposition called no class today. It is also a primitive statement because you cannot break it down further. When you try to combine these two, we get one more proposition, which I call it as compound proposition. So I also tell that connectives are basically used to create new proposition. So I have one proposition, today is Wednesday, another proposition, no class today. So when I combine this, I get a new proposition. That's why I say using connectives, I can try to create new propositions, which are called as the compound propositions. Using more than two propositions, I try to combine, then I call it as a compound proposition. Am I clear till here? Give me some quick responses, please.
Ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Ma'am, it's clear.
Yeah, fine. You can stop me anytime that you want. If you have any issues with respect to network or voice, audio, video, or if you have any doubts with whatever I'm teaching you, please stop me then and there. I'll be at the other side. I don't know. I'm not at the Google Meet, right? Please stop me and ask. No issues. Let's come back to this. I told there are two kind of things. One is called as transform and another is combine. Generally, we don't call this transform as a connective. Transform means what? What do you mean by transform?
Right. Transforming from one type to another.
Try to change or try to put it in a different form. What you listed out all this creation. All under all the others are all under negation. Don't use negation. Combine propositions. Don't use it. Use negation. Transform it or to change it or in the format. That is what you use negation. You can't combine two propositions using negation, that is, but still transform it, that change it into a, take some, start with negation. I have told you so far what we did. I told you what are basic connectives. Of two types again, transform and combine. We discussed what are connectives, why they are used, and what are compound propositions. We took an example of compound proposition. I also told you the difference between transform and combine. This conjunction, disjunction, implication, biconditional, all this will form under combine, form under fall under and negation will fall. Hope I'm clear till here.
Yes, ma'am.
Let us move further. Start with negation. All of you would have learned some kind of digital electronics, kind of basic gates. Yes or no?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am. This means 0 to 1, 1 to 0, like that, ma'am.
Right. We all would have learned negation, not gate, and gate, or gate. Yes or no? We would have learned all that. Is it not in your graduation? Somewhere you would have touched upon these things. Negation is a transform, I said. That means, given anything, I can try to transform it into a different form. For example, suppose I take P is a preposition. Negation of that would be represented as negation of P. If you get back to your logic gates, how do you represent? This is our simple NOT gate. How many inputs and how many inputs outputs they have?
One input, one output.
Exactly. One input and one output, and that gets toggled. Toggled means if it is yes, it becomes no. If it is no, other, if I can also represent that is exactly what we are going to see negation in terms of. If I take P as a preposition, negation of P. What we are trying to say, not of P or negation of. Take an example. Let us say P is what, I will take some example. Bangalore of COVID. Example. Proposition. Suppose I will have to write negation of P. How do I write this?
Bangalore is not free of COVID.
Not free of COVID.
Right. Bangalore is not free of COVID. Clear? This is your negation of P. If it is true, it becomes false. If it is false, if it becomes true. Suppose I take, it is not necessary that negation should always have not like this. Okay. I can also take P as Bangalore is not free of. Is not free of COVID. In that case, for me, negation of P will be Bengaluru is free of COVID. So that is how we try to write. If I go in for the truth table of negation, or I go into the truth table, how many of y'all can, if you know what is a truth table?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Yeah, all of you know. Can anybody define a truth table?
A truth table is a table where 0 and 1s are there.
Zeros and 1s are represented in the tabular form. That is okay. But what is it?
Combination of all inputs and its output.
Combination of inputs and outputs. Okay. Any other answer?
Possible inputs and possible outputs, ma'am.
Representation of possible inputs and possible outputs. Okay. Now, we try to define truth table. Truth table is nothing but the relationship between the truth values of the propositions are represented in the form of a truth table. The relationship between truth values. When I say Bangalore is free of COVID, the truth value of that proposition could be either it could be true or it could be false. Now, when I try to show the relationships of these truth values of different propositions, I put it in the form of a table, which I call it as truth table. Am I clear?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Yeah. Now let us try to write what is the truth table for negation. Suppose I take P, output is going to be, this is your input, this is your output. Okay, so if I take P as a proposition, negation of P is going to be the output. So if I try to write the truth table, I will get if this is true, this is false. If this is P is false, then negation of P becomes true. This is the simplest truth table of a negation, right? Now, so we took a very simple example. Bangalore is free of COVID. That is a proposition P. So negation of P becomes Bangalore is not free of COVID becomes the negation, right? Now, let me give you all one more example for writing the negation. All right. My PC has at least 32 GB of free disk space. This is a proposition. What did I give? My PC has at least 32 GB of free disk space. Can you write the negation of P? Write the negation of P and tell me what would be the negation of P. My PC has at least 32 GB of free disk space.
My PC has 32 GB of space. Free disk space.
Yeah, sorry. You have to say the negation.
Negation. List.
My PC doesn't even have 32 GB of free disk space.
All right. So one answer I got, my PC, if I have to write this, my PC does not have 32 GB of free disk space. I hope all of you have written it like this. Yes?
Yes, ma'am. Does not.
So my PC does not have 32 GB of free disk space. This is the right way of writing it. I'm not denying that.
Ma'am, at most we can.
Sorry, ma'am.
At most.
No, you cannot use at most here. At least there is free disk space 32 GB. How do you bring a negation there? At most is not the negation. Tell me the full sentence what you have written.
My PC has at most 32 GB of free disk space.
No. It's wrong. See, all of you have written it like this. You have to bring in the negation there. Where is the negation? See, my PC does not have 32 GB of the free disk space. This is the simplest way of putting. But what I'm trying to tell you here is negation can also be written in different form. For example, I can also write negation of P as, I have written my PC doesn't have 32 GB of free disk space. Okay. I can also write, it is not the case that my PC has at least 32 GB of free disk space. This is another way of writing the negation. It is not the case that my PC has at least 32 GB of free disk space. It is not the case. So that is where your negation comes in. There is another way of writing it. What can I write? My PC has less than 32 GB of free disk space. This is also right. You can write the negation of P. This is simplest way. All are right. Don't worry. All are right. This is simplest what we wrote the first one. It's a very simple way of writing. You can also write it in this way. It is not the case that my PC has at least 32 GB of free disk space. Then you can also write my PC has less than 32 GB of free disk space. All are correct as far as the negation is concerned. Are you clear?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, shall we proceed?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. So this is what you call negation, as I said, comes under, as I told you all, it comes under transform. That means you are trying to represent whatever proposition is given. You are trying to put it in a different form. That's all. That is why it comes under transform. It will not come under combine because you are not connecting two or more propositions there. Right? Okay. So now let us move on to the next one. Next one is what? We go in for conjunction. Now, conjunction is same as your logical AND. Okay? So, if you try to write a truth table, how many inputs and how many input outputs a conjunction should have?
Two inputs, one output.
Right?
Yes, ma'am.
Try to put down the truth table. This is P and Q are propositions, and then I write P and Q, which is the conjunction. Right? So, what are the possible combinations? Both can be true and false, false and true. Right? When we talk of logical AND or conjunction, the output P and Q is going to be true when both the inputs are true. All other cases, it will be right.
Yes, ma'am.
So, yes, true, ma'am. And true, yes, true and true is true. This would be false. This is false. This is also false. That is what is conjunction. Let us take a simple example. P. Let the proposition P be, today is Sunday. This is a proposition. Now, I will take one more proposition. No class today. Can you write what is
false? The false statement.
Sorry?
Today is not a Sunday, and but there no is class today. But today is a class. Today is not a Sunday, but
today is not a Sunday. Why you went for not a Sunday? Did I ask you to write negation?
No, ma'am. That false statement. That P will be the false, sir, and become false statement, ma'am. Both also.
No, I am not talking of false or true here at all. I am only telling how you can write a conjunction. Conjunction is what? It is a connective which is used to combine two propositions using the AND operator.
Okay.
No class.
You are going to combine P and Q using this operator AND. There is no need of any negation here, is it not?
Yes, ma'am.
Why you said today is not Sunday? That is wrong. I said there are two propositions. P, today is Sunday. Q, no class today. How do you write what is called as P and Q?
Today is Sunday and not class today.
That's all. Exactly. Today is Sunday. And this is what is what required here. And no class today. That is called as conjunction. Any doubts, anyone? Because somebody heard, I mean, I don't know who told that negation and all that. Any doubts?
No, ma'am.
No, ma'am.
All right. Take down one more example. You write down. Let P be the proposition. My smartphone has at least 32 GB of free disk space. My smartphone has at least 32 GB of free disk space. That is P. Done?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, my smartphone has at least 32 GB of free disk space. That is my proposition P. Now, my proposition Q. Proposition Q is he's the name of a person. His phone, this is a PC, runs at a speed of 1.5 gigahertz. This PC runs at a speed of 1.5 gigahertz. Write down what is P and Q. What is P and Q?
My phone has at least 32 GB of free disk space, and B's PC runs at 1.5 gigahertz.
Exactly.
Yes, ma'am.
What about others? Have you all written the same?
Yes, ma'am. Same.
Yeah, you have to just add an and, that's all. Have you all done? Shall we proceed?
Yes, ma'am.
Yeah, that's about. Now let's move on to this junction. Junction. This junction is represented by this one. Okay, so junction is represented with this particular symbol. The same as your logical. Let me write down the truth table. P and Q are the two propositions. Then we have four possible combinations. False and true. Does OR work?
True, false.
Even if one of the input is going to be true, output will be true. If both are false, students.
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Yeah. So disjunction, we brought out the truth table. For the same example that we had taken in the last one, you can even try writing the disjunction. So when you try writing disjunction, what will happen? What you have to include? Suppose I say
or,
ma'am.
Or.
Yeah. Suppose I say today is Sunday. We'll take the same example. Today is Sunday is my P. My Q would be no class today. No class today. Then how do we write P or Q?
Today is Sunday, no class today.
No class today.
Yeah. Today is Sunday or no class. Okay, that's how you write. For the same example that we saw in the previous case, that is, yeah, my smartphone has 32 GB, whatever example we saw, for that also you can write the P or Q, which would be instead of and, you will be replacing it with or. That is disjunction. Clear to you all?
Yes, ma'am.
Shall we proceed to the next one?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Next we will go on to what is called as conditional statements. Now when we talk of conditional statements, there are two things. One is called as the implication. The second one you call it as biconditional. So one is implication, then the other one is biconditional. I had told these two when we listed out the basic connectives. I had listed out these two also. But these two will come under conditional statements. When I say implication, this is how we try to represent implication. When I say biconditional, it is always represented as a, it's always represented as a double-headed arrow. Okay? So when I say P implies Q, we can always say if P then Q. Okay, if P then Q. If it is a biconditional, one second please, one second. Okay, so when we talk of biconditional, we say P if and only if Q. Okay, implication means what? P implies Q. If P, then Q. That is your implication. Okay, so we represent that as, let us take a simple example. Let us take two propositions. P. P is what? Today is holiday. That is P. Q is what? Store is closed. That is Q. Okay. Now, can you tell me how will you write P implies Q?
If today is holiday, then store is closed.
Exactly. You should always bring in this if then implication. If there is a condition P, then Q will hold. Q holds based on the P's condition. If I say this, if today is then store is closed. This is what you call it as implication. Any doubts so far?
No, ma'am.
No, ma'am.
There are different variations or different ways in which you can represent this. What are the other ways? One is, I told, if P then Q. This said, how do you read it?
Thank you.
Now, there are different terminologies which you can use in order to express E implying Q. You can have different terminologies which will express this particular thing. Okay, so first one, as I already told you, if P, then it is Q. Second one is, you can even write it as, if P, instead of saying, if P, then Q, you can also write it as, if P, comma, instead of then. You need not bring in if, then, always. Are you getting what I'm trying to say?
Yeah.
Yes, ma'am. Yes, ma'am.
Yeah. You can also write it as Q if P. Okay? Q if P. That is also right. How do you write this example? Can you tell me?
For
Q is used if today is holiday.
First case, P, comma, Q, you write it.
Today is holiday.
And here.
Today is holiday.
Today is holiday.
Then we not come.
That's
right. If you say, who if P?
Right, store is closed.
Store is closed. Today.
Store is closed. Today is also called as. This is the basic way of writing. Other ways, different ways. This is also possible. Store is closed. And it is holiday. Is your Q and yes, also right. Door is closed unless it is not a holiday. Can it as question of negation of P, you have to bring in the negation. P is of P.
Is Sunday.
It is closed unless not. Right. Write that. Read that example.
Today is holiday only if store is closed.
Today is holiday only if store is closed. Others, are you all able to follow me?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Never P. whenever?
Store is closed whenever
today is holiday.
Store is closed whenever today is holiday. That is also implication. Okay. Then the simplest one is P implies Q that we have already seen. This is nothing but your P implies Q. Am I clear to all of you?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Now, let us look at the truth table of P implies Q. What would be the truth table? Let us take the possible combinations. True, 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 false, false and true, false and false. Right? So, P implies Q will be will be false when P is true and Q is false. When P is true, Q is false, P implies Q will be false. That you should remember, this condition. It's a very important one. Rest all the conditions, irrespective of true or false, it is going to be true. Getting me? P implies Q is false. So when P is true and Q is false, P implies Q will be false. But when P is true, for all other conditions, your P implies Q will be this truth table. So far we have seen conjunction, disjunction, and or not, these kind of things which all of you know. Now you have to think about you have to start remembering certain things. Maybe some of them are new for you. P implies Q, you might not have come across. Maybe when P is true and Q is false, you have to take it as false. Then you have to take it as false. The rest all the conditions, your P implies Q will be true. Am I clear?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Yeah.
Yes, ma'am.
You should always bring in this if then whenever you are talking of propositions in terms of P implies Q. You should always bring in if then condition there. Clear?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Right. Next, we will see Next we will see what is some problems starting again. Exclusive OR.
So ma'am, what about biconditional?
Sorry?
What about biconditional statement?
I'll come back to that. I actually left out exclusive OR. That's why I went back to that. I'll come back to that. Don't worry.
Okay, ma'am. Okay.
Actually, I should have finished exclusive OR and then gone for conditional statements. I somehow missed this exclusive OR. That's why I remember. Now I came back. I'm sorry. Okay. So let us take two propositions, P or Q. How do you represent exclusive OR? Exclusive OR is represented like this. Correct? Can anybody tell me the truth values? If both are true, what will happen? False, false, true, false, false. What will happen now? Can anybody tell me?
Ma'am, true for P and Q. If it is true, then P or Q will be true.
Sorry, ma'am. First one is what?
First one is
false, ma'am. False, Bharata.
False, Bharata. True.
False, ma'am. 0110.
Okay. So this will be false. This will false. Also be false. These two will be
true.
This is your exclusive OR truth table. True and true is false. False and false is also false. True and false is true. False and true is also Okay, to you all, this is exclusive OR. There's another way of representing exclusive OR. This is the symbol for exclusive OR. One more symbol. Right?
Yes, ma'am.
Any doubt?
No, ma'am.
Okay. Biconditional, probably I'll take it up in the next class because I don't want to break it in between. That's why. Okay, so far we have seen the different VSC. We saw what is a primitive statement and how it can be combined and all that in the last class. We saw what is the, let me give you a quick recap. We saw what is combined and we saw what is a transform, right? We saw these two things and then we saw what are the basic connectives.
Conjunction, disjunction, implication by...
Conjunction, disjunction, negation. First we saw transform was negation.
Transform, negation.
Yes. And then we went into conjunction, disjunction, exclusive OR. And then had to come for the conditional statements. Under conditional statements, we have implication as well as biconditional. So we have done up to implications and we also saw what are the different ways in which you can represent the implication. That is also, that also we have seen. So given that, biconditional onwards, so we will take it up in the next class. Any doubts so far, whatever we have done?
No, ma'am.
No, ma'am.
Okay. Let me take your attendance.
Ma'am, do we have a lab classes today?
Whose lab is there as per timetable? Online labs, probably, I don't know, you may not have, otherwise, because we'll start it off, anyway, you are all joining offline next week. We'll have some extra lab classes for you all and try to... So online lab, I don't know, you have to talk to your concerned teachers when you are, when they are taking the theory classes. All right?
Okay, ma'am.
Yeah, it'll be better because they may have some plans. So it's better they reply you on that. Thanks for your attendance. Anaga?
Present, ma'am.
Okay. Akrut?
Yes, ma'am.
Bargav?
Yes, ma'am.
Yesterday you didn't attend, Bhargav?
No, ma'am.
Why?
Issue with network, ma'am.
Rahmatullah? Charan? Darshan?
Present, ma'am.
Uma Bushra? Divya?
Yes, ma'am.
Kaushik?
Present, ma'am.
Manish?
Present, ma'am.
Manoj? Purnima? Purnima? Rashmi? Rupak?
Yes, ma'am.
Sai Kumar? Shadab Ansari?
Present, ma'am.
Sri Vishnu?
Present, ma'am.
Sugandini?
Present, ma'am.
Sushma? Sushma? She's not there. Varsha?
Yes, ma'am.
All right. So I think
ma'am, that's all for today.
Yeah, tell me, ma'am.
Ma'am, no, you didn't call my name.
I didn't call your name?
No, ma'am.
Okay, fine. Anyone else? I think I've called everybody. Yeah, I think that's all for today, and then we'll continue again tomorrow's class. Okay, thank you.
Thank you, ma'am.
Thank you, ma'am.